learners, this is Elina Mishra. Welcome to Snape's Biology. In the last class, we have studied about racemose inflorescence. In this part, we will discuss about cymose inflorescence and some special type of inflorescence. So let's start. So we know in cymose inflorescence, the main axis is always terminate into a flower and every branch also terminate into flower. So we divided it into various type on the basis of how many branches are produced every time. So first one is known as uniparous cyme, or it is also known as monocasial cyme. So in uniparous cyme, every time only one branch will be produced. Now this is further divided into two categories. One is called helicoid cyme and the other is known as scorpioid cyme. Helicoid means the branches which arise, they always arise on the same side. So look at the diagram. There is the main axis which is terminate into the flower. Now if it give rise to the branch, the branches on the right side, it also terminate into a flower. It again produce a branch that also terminates into a flower. And every time it is coming on the right side. Now we draw it in this manner to understand it. But in normal case, the main axis is always look vertical. But to keep the orientation straight, they have flowers or branches only one side. Here we have drawn the branches only on right side. It could be on left side also. But if it is in left side, then all on the left. And if it is on the right side, then all are always remain on the right. So the term helicoid is given because it takes a clockwise turn. That means it moves only in one direction. So if it is moving in one direction, we will call it helicoid. Or in other words, if all the branches are produced in the same side, then that will be called helicoid. So helicoid type of inflorescence is seen in case of Solanaceae family, Heliotropium, etc. Next, the second one is scorpioid. So in case of scorpioid, the term is given on the basis of snake-like movements. That means the branches are produced in zigzag manners. So look at the diagram. There is the main axis which terminate into a flower. The branch is on the right, next is on the left, then right, then left, then right. So if we draw it, it is going to be zigzag. So names have been given on the basis of side of branching, but every time there is only one branch which is produced. So scorpioid type of inflorescence are found in case of ranunculus, that means zigzag manner. But in both these cases, there is only one branch which is produced at a time. So we called it uniparous or monocasial. Next, if every time two branches are produced, then we will call it biparous cyme or dicasial cyme. So every time there would be two branches produced. So look at the diagram. There is the main axis which terminates into a flower. Now when the branching takes place, every time from the same point, there would be two branch which would arise and both are going to terminate into a flower. Then they produce branch. Always again two branches would be produced. So this is the main axis. It terminates into a flower. Every time there are two, and when there are further branching, these are the third time branching. Then this is known as biparous cyme. This is seen in case of Bougainvillea, Mirabilis, etc. Now, if every time there are many branches which are produced, then it is known as the third type, that is multiparous cyme or polycasial. And this is seen in case of Calotropis. In Calotropis, every time there would be multiple branches produced. So look at the diagram. There is the main branch which is terminates into a flower. Now if it produce branches, number of branches is going to be many. All these branches is going to terminate into flowers. When they produce branches, again everyone would produce multiple branches. And all these branches would again terminate into flower. So this is known as multiparous or polycasial cyme. So the characteristic features are retained in all the types, that is main axis is always terminate into a flower. Now depending upon the number of branches they are produced, we have uni, bi and multiparous cyme. In uniparous cyme, there are two possibilities. One, when all the branches are produced on the same side, it could be right, or left, which is seen in case of Solanaceae family, and we called it helicoid. And if the branches are zigzag, left, then we called it scorpioid sign, which is seen in ranunculus. Two branches every time, then we called it biparous. Many branches every time, that is multiparous. So these three are the types of cymose inflorescence. So we have already discussed racemose and its types and cymose and its type. Now we will talking about three special type of inflorescence. And the first one is hypanthodium. So hypanthodium inflorescence are found in ficus variety. So we can take the example of fig, which is Ficus carica. So in ficus variety, we find hypanthodium inflorescence. Now in this type, the axis or the part to which the flowers are attached becomes thick, vase-like or flask-like structure. So look at the diagram. There is the receptacle or the axis on which the flowers are attached. It becomes thick and there is a space inside, and we find three types of flowers inside the space. The flowers which are towards the neck region, they are represented only by stamens. So these are the male flowers. Now on the lower sides are present the female flowers. The female flowers, they are two types. One is fertile female flowers and other one is sterile female flowers or girl flowers. And sterile female flowers are present in between the fertile female flowers. Now the interesting thing in here is for reproduction also. Why this kind of flowers are present? What happens is in fig, the pollination is done by wasp, which is commonly known as girl wasp, and its scientific name is Blastophaga. So there is a mutual relationship between the hypanthodium inflorescence and the wasp. What happens is the wasp enter into this hypanthodium and lays its egg in the sterile flowers. So when the wasp enters up to the bottom of the hypanthodium to lays the egg, it has to come through this narrow passage, which is known as osteole. So when the wasp comes in and goes out, the pollen grains are going to stick to the body and wings of the wasp. Now wasp goes into another hypanthodium again. It is going to enter through the same passage. As the passage is narrow, the wings are going to touch the wall and pollen grains going to fall on the flowers present there. And when the pollen grains are land on the fertile female flowers, cross-pollination is going to take place. So there is a mutual benefit to both. What happens to the wasp? Wasp gets the secure place for egg laying and the hypanthodium gets cross-pollinated. So this complete structure is called the hypanthodium inflorescence. Three types of flowers. The neck part has male flowers and the lower parts has female flowers, both sterile and fertile flowers. And the axis to which the flowers are attached, this has become swollen, vase-like structure known as receptacle. So hypanthodium is the very special type of inflorescence with incomplete male and female flowers. The next special type is known as verticillister. We find this inflorescence in Osimum and Salvia. So what exactly is this inflorescence? Look at the diagram. It is the combination of biparous cyme and uniparous cyme. We know in cymose, the main axis is always terminate into a flower. So here also main axis is end with a flower. It shows branching and the branching is going to be two every time. So this is biparous cyme. Second time, when there is a branching, again the branches would be two and terminates into a flower. So that means for the second time it was behaving like biparous cyme. After this, look at the fourth diagram, only one branch is produced every time. So now from here, from that branch, one branch produced, again one and again one. That means now it is behaving like uniparous cyme. But we can tell from this diagram that it is one branch arise, but it is going in zigzag manner. That means it is uniparous scorpioid cyme. So this inflorescence is biparous for one or two times and then it is uniparous scorpioid cyme. So it is the combination of two, and it is mainly found in the Lamiaceae family plants. Next, the third type of inflorescence is known as cythium. Look at the diagram. In the diagram, we find that there is a brightly colored structure which is more or less a flask-like or vase-like. And we find that there are stamens or male flowers coming out of this brightly colored vase-like structure. And we also find one pistil or female flower. But as we are talking about cythium under the head of inflorescence, that means this is not the single flower. Now, if we cut the longitudinal section, we find out that all the stamens, they are going up to here, are attached, and there are many more which are inside. That means there are some smaller ones also which is not visible to us from outside. And this brightly colored structure is actually the involucre or spathe. And this stamen, they are actually the male flowers, and the female flower is present at the middle. That means in this inflorescence has many male flowers which is represented only by stamens, and one female flower which is represented by pistil. This inflorescence mainly found in Euphorbiaceae family plants. For example, poinsettia. So these are the important inflorescences which are mainly found. Next, we will discuss about flowers and its part. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon for more updates. Thank you.